We've got a couple practice problems here involving finding present value and future value of annuities. Walter and Beth Bates save $1,200 at the end of each quarter for 7 years. Assume 8% compounded quarterly. Find the future value and the lump sum or present value that must be deposited today to accumulate the same future value. So let's take care of the first problem. They're asking us for the future value of this savings plan. We need to calculate the interest rate per compounding period. So we'll take the 8% divided by 4 because of the frequency of the compounding quarterly per year. 8% divided by 4 gives us the 2%. How many compounding periods? Quarterly means 4 per year. For the 7 years, there's 28 compounding periods. And we're determining the future value. So we'll look on a future value table, find the intersection of our I and N, which is this value, multiply it by the regular savings or deposit, means that in 7 years, this savings plan, if they follow it through, will have a balance of $44,461.45. The second part asks us, what would we need as a lump sum today to accomplish that same value as their plan of putting $1,200 every quarter for the next 7 years? So we're looking for the present value or lump sum that's equivalent and will generate that same value 7 years from now. Our I and our N are the same. So we're looking at 2% and 28 for I and N respectively, but we're going to use the present value table. They will intersect with this value. We will multiply it by the 1200, which means we would need a wheelbarrow filled with $25,537.52 deposited today, put it there, forget about it, and in 7 years, we would find a balance on the account equivalent to the original game plan of regular $1,200 every quarter, every 3 months of Walter and Beth's first plan. This next problem has Deborah Short expecting to receive $20,940 per year in Social Security payments. Assume that she receives these payments for 28 years. Use a rate of 6% per year. Find the present value of her retirement payment. We want to find what that lump sum needs to be today in order to pay out this amount each year for the next 28 years. Now, it's not 28 times this amount because we're only taking off a little less than $21,000 off from this lump sum. But in the meantime, over the course of the years, the remaining balance is still compounding interest. So our lump sum is less than the actual total payout because of this interest compounding. They're asking us for present value. We need to find out what our interest rate per compounding period is. It's telling us it is earning a 6% per year. So that would be once per year, isn't changing our interest rate. Number of compounding periods. The per year means once per year for 28 years, we have an N. We're determining what the lump sum today needs to be in an account so that Deborah receives this amount of payment each year. So we will look on our present value table for the I of 6% and the N of 28. There's the value, timesing it by the payment she expects to receive. This is what the Social Security Department would have on hand to ensure that there was enough money to meet that payment per year for Deborah. As a little note, it's telling us, and I kind of went over this, but her Social Security retirement payments have a present value that we just found. In other words, the Social Security payments equate to having cash of this $280,700, almost $25 at the time of her retirement. Her total payments received during the 28 years, if we take the yearly payment times the 28 years, you can see the total amount received is a little more than double that amount. And the reason they can get away with this smaller is, as I said, the remaining balance is earning interest and continues to generate income to help meet that annual payment out for her Social Security. In this next example, Tish Baker plans to retire from nursing at age 65 and hopes to withdraw $25,000 per year until she's 90. If money earns 8% per year compounded annually, how much will she need at age 65? So we're looking for that present value. Second question is her planning of this lump sum that she needs to meet her financial goals during her retirement. If she deposits $2,000 per year into a retirement plan beginning at age 32, and if the plan earns 8% per year compounded annually, will her retirement account have enough for her to meet her goals? So on this problem, we need to first find out what that lump sum is when she retires at age 65 to accomplish the $25,000 per year until she's 95. So we need to find our I. 8% is what her during her retirement years earning per year. So our I per compound interest rate per compounding period, in other words, I is sitting at 8%. The one doesn't change it. How many compounding periods, in other words, how many years will she receive this money if she's retiring at 65 and she wants it to last until she's 90? We'll take the 90 minus 65 means there's 25 years compounded annually, so our N is 25. Looking that up on the present value table, using that I and N, we get the following multiplier. She's going to receive payments of $25,000. So when she retires at 65, the lump sum needed for that goal to be met is this number here, almost $267,000. Will she have enough money with her savings plan that was given to us in Part B? So we need to calculate out her future value of her savings plan. She's going to put $2,000 in an account paying 8% per year, so our I is 8%. Per year is once. She's starting at age 32. The plan is to retire at 65, which means she's going to be doing this for 33 years. Once per year for 33 years gives us an N of 33. On the future value, we will look up our I and N that we found. There's our multiplier. Times that by her yearly or annually deposited $2,000 means that in 33 years, this is what her bank account's value will have, almost $292,000. She has certainly met her goal. She has more saved in a retirement account than what she needs as a lump sum at the beginning of the retirement to ensure that she gets her $25,000 a year for the 25 years until she's 90. So good news. One thing that she is basing this on is an assumption that she's earning 8% per year on her savings. Banks aren't going to pay 8%, so she will need to go to a stocks or bonds, mutual funds, some other investment that's paying a higher interest rate.